If you haven't published, you're nothing. You're nothing to them. And to the world at large, you're nothing. It's all about money, publishing, you know, the industry, the business. And so, you know, always, so, but that slows you down so severely. You're publishing and not practicing. So the Holy Spirit said, don't publish, practice. Don't publish, practice. And again, in India, when Sri Sri Anandamayi was there, it was all about building temples and hospitals, clinics and stuff, temples. Not publishing so much, no. So those that came to her, they all wanted, like, could you sponsor a temple? Can I name a temple after you? I want to build a hospital. Can I name the hospital after you? They're obsessed with, you know, building hospitals and temples and stuff. And she said, always say, we have plenty of hospitals, plenty of temples, but more than enough buildings. I want you to practice. What I'm here for is to encourage you to practice. That's all. Her whole thing was to encourage you to practice. That's it. Because when you practice, you're going to succeed for sure. If you don't practice, you won't succeed for sure. So it's all about practicing, practicing, practicing. And they'd say, well, okay, but I need to build a temple too. So she said, well, just make sure an hour every morning you practice. And they say, well, it takes an hour out of my temple building. I want to build a big mandir, a big temple. I want to build something, you know, awesome. Let's get, you know. She said, no, we don't need any more temples. Eventually there was a hospital built in Varanasi after her name. They wanted to build schools too. Well, I want to build an orphanage. I want to build a school. Got to have a school, got to have an orphanage, got to have a hospital, got to have temples, got to build. And she says, what I'm looking for is those who want to practice. She says, there's nothing wrong with temples and hospitals and orphanages. Just goes, fine, that's nothing wrong with that. In fact, there's probably some good from that, right? But she says, what I'm here for is to inspire you to practice, to free yourself from this delusion of the ocean of samsara. This is what I'm here for. Not to work on building hospitals for you. So this is what the teachers tell us. So it's not about publishing. It's about practicing. Now with these videos, it's great because I am practicing. The video is the practice. And I'm able to publish this also, but in Creative Commons, you know, instant publishing, available for everyone in the world, free of charge, see? With no copyright issues at all, see? Very different, very different. So it's setting an example. This is setting an example. I said others could do this too. I don't know why they aren't doing it. You can also use as your practice. Instead of publishing, instead of going to this spiritual circus, remain a recluse, but at the same time, you can publish your practice in Creative Commons. And as you do this, you get more and more free, actually, of the whole situation. But you don't have to do that either. Maybe it's better for you just to be quiet and silent and remain a recluse. See, I don't need to be famous. God is famous. God already is famous. Inherently so. So just come and realize God. Fame. That's the real fame right there. God is the one that is famous. And of course, we're an extension of God, but God is the prime creator. God created us. We didn't create God. So instead of you being famous, experience fame, real fame. Experience real fame. Instead of trying to be out in the spiritual circus and try, look at me, you know, I'm famous. Instead of that, experience true fame, which is God. The fame that never fades away. Fame that has no downs to it. perpetual, endless, eternal theme. Sometimes, or oftentimes, the famous are the ones who actually get on the path. Like for instance, remember Greta Garbo? She's like, I just want to be alone. So, get me out of the limelight, you know, forget it. There are those who've been in the limelight, and then they say, I cannot take any more of this, forget it. I don't want to be the limelight. I want God. God's the limelight. I just want to experience the limelight of God without me having to create it or sustain it. You see, because when you're famous, you have to create the fame and sustain the fame, and it's a nightmare. You get all these agents around you, they steal your money, they control your life. Yeah, the agents, the entourage, you get an entourage, managers, agents, booking this, booking that, dealing with the money. The investments, blah, 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 blah. The gawkers, the aggressive autograph seekers, the aggressive fame seekers. Hey, hey, let me shake your hand. I just want to be alone. I just want to be alone. I just want to be alone. Wow. So sometimes, the famous ones have been famous in the limelight in various ways. They end up being hardcore on the spiritual path. They get down to business. They say, I'm done with me. Forget it. I'm done with it. That's why sometimes you see these ex-actors and actresses and ex-famous people going to see real gurus and becoming great devotees. Just like they're done with it permanently. They say, I want to get free of this nightmare, this dualistic nightmare, this hallucination, this ocean of samsara. I want to get free of it. Well, how do we get free of it? Realize it's never existed. It doesn't exist. It's a dream. It's unreal. It's fake. It's an imagining that's being sustained by our belief that we created God. And so we're saying, how do I get this smooth, this ocean, which is based on the belief that I created God and I'm sustaining God. So how do we keep this smooth, you know? Smooth it out. We can't. Because we keep forgetting, now, how did I create God? And how am I going to sustain God? We can never figure it out, can we? Can't figure it out. So we're tossing and turning of try this, try that. Wait a minute, that doesn't work. Let's try this. Let's pile this on. Let's amplify this. I think I might have it. No, I don't have it. I'm depressed. Up and down, up and down, up and down. And all around. This tossing ocean of some sort. Conditioned existence. Of ups and downs. Where I am, there is no down. Where I am, there is no doubt. Where I am, there is no doubt. But most of the world craves fame and fortune, don't they? Most of them, that's what they're frantically after. Want to get a bigger yacht. You think that'll smooth out the ocean for them? Bigger crew, you know. They can be happy that it's biggest yacht and the biggest crew sailing to the coolest ports. And say, I haven't got it made, you know. I've got it made. And they're sitting there drinking their alcohol and taking their drugs and partying. And say, sometime maybe in the evening or the morning after, somebody just sitting there and says, you know. I just gotta get a bigger yacht. This isn't quite it. This isn't quite it for me. Gotta get a bigger yacht. Gotta get a bigger island. How do I do that? I'm not sure. these things are falling apart. I don't like the crew. Maybe I'll fire some of the crew. Something's just not quite right. Yeah. Then this feeling comes in. What's that feeling? It feels like death is death or something. It feels like some terrible depression. It feels like some terrible failure. If they could recognize it, you could flip the script and say, hey, where I am, there is no doubt. See, we keep interpreting that as death, to be avoided. And so we keep dying to avoid what we think is annihilation. Of what? Of our belief that we created God and we're sustaining God. So, as long as we believe that, that we're trying to sustain it, we'll avoid it. We'll avoid realization by dying. After death, we think we've escaped the realization that there is no down. Where I am, there is no down. I didn't create this and I'm not sustaining it. And I'm perfectly blissful, happy here. To avoid that, we've invented this dying. So as long as we're avoiding this, we're going to keep on dying. There's no way around it. But when we accept this, we don't need to die anymore. We don't need it. Don't need it anymore. That's why they say it's the final birth. No return. Don't make anything of it. Don't make anything of it, because everyone will realize this. Everyone will. It's absolutely, in fact, they already have. In time, they're still playing out time. They're honoring a time. But everyone's already dropped this nonsense already. We're just realizing this is so. So don't make anything up. For me, if this is often the way it is, you hear the stories like someone has a realization, the master says, well, great, okay, now you're going to be a grave digger. That's your job. What? Are you kidding? I need to go to princesses and princes and kings and queens and Maharaj. I need to go and tell everybody I'm enlightened and explain it. Wow. No, you need to go. Your job now is to be a grave digger. Huh? See, for me, my job is to take garbage to the dump. I said, wait a minute, I'm having all these realizations and peak experiences and wows that are like, I should be publishing books and being on the talk circuit and be on television and everything. I should be on Oprah, are you kidding me? I said, no, your job is to take garbage to the dump. So I'm there at the dump, all the seagulls crapping on my head, you know? And surrounded by the stench of the dump and this garbage. And I'm saying, wait a minute, I realize, you know, non-dual realization, I understand the whole thing, but here I am with seagulls crapping on my head. And then I just kind of look around. Say, okay. Don't make a big deal. Don't make anything of it, okay? And then, suddenly, all the seagulls are on the ground, they go settle down, and someone shoots off a flare. And like 5,000 seagulls, white seagulls, suddenly arise all at once and fly as one through the sky with this beautiful azure blue background. And I'm just standing there, just like, whoa. And they're flying right over my head. Hear the sound of wings. The whole sky is filled with these white birds against this total blue background. Flying. I just stop. Just watch. Wow. sight to behold. That is a sight to behold. So this often how it works, you know, the ones that are really far along oftentimes have very lowly jobs. Struggling. Why? To protect them from the big time, you know? The so-called big time is a protection. It's like I always say, I don't have any money, I can't go anywhere, I can't do anything, I can't even travel to any one of these conferences at all. I can't even attend any conference. I have no money to pay the attendance fee. I don't have money for gas to go there or travel there. I can't fly anywhere. I don't have money. I can't do anything. That's a protection. Because if I go to a conference, I'd say, wait a minute. I'm way farther along than this or something. But, hey, folks, you know, let me tell you something. And then I just get pulled into it, you know? This way, I can't get pulled into anything. It's like, what do you do? Pick up trash and take it to the dump. Oh, really? So where have you been? I've been nowhere in my whole life. I've just been in the same place. Oh, really? Well, where'd you graduate from? I didn't. I dropped out of college. Oh. Oh. Really? Well, who are the teachers you've been seeing? These? I really haven't gone to see any teachers. Okay. Well, how nice. That's great. How nice. Okay. Nice to meet you. Like that. No status, you see. So you can't have anyone glom onto you. You got no status. Can't have anyone hook onto you. These conferences are full of spiritual hookers. You know, everyone's just a spiritual hooker there. They want to hook onto you, right? Hook onto you. You just say, I don't have any status at all. Well, why are you here again? I don't know. Just how it's worked out. That's weird. It's weird. You're weird. That's pretty weird. I don't know. I kind of feel uncomfortable. It's kind of weird. Who do you know? Who do you know? I really don't know anyone in the business. Oh. Well, have you published any? No. Well, have a nice life. Have a nice life. You too. Have a nice life. Well, maybe you should go see someone in Costa Rica. You should go see them, or someone over there in Varanasi. I can't really afford to do that. Oh, really? Can't afford to? Oh, huh? I don't really have the time. I gotta work. I can't afford it. So it's funny, I don't understand how people can do things at all. But actually it's a blessing to not be able to do anything here. So it's like the Holy Spirit somehow intentionally put a block on me. But I can't figure out how to make money or do stuff at all. I don't understand it. I draw a blank, complete blank. I see people going places in the whole world, all this activity. I don't have a clue how they're managing to do that. I don't understand it in the slightest bit. See, for me, this is totally normal. And what they're doing is just bizarre. Totally bizarre. I look at television, I see these people doing stuff, and it's completely bizarre. They're going on airplanes, they're flying places, they're attending this. How the heck can you attend a conference and pay $4,000 and spend like a week and a half attending a conference with hotels, with food, with travel? I mean, who can do that? It's just, I don't understand at all how it's possible. And yet, these are packed. All sorts of young people. How can you be young and do the work? What? It's totally bizarre and weird to me. Blessing in the skies. Again, the great teachers tell us, if you have a life that you're low and humble and suffering and you can't do much and you're just all you can do is practice, you're totally blessed. You're super blessed. That's how God blesses Sri Sri Anandamayi. He said, God gives you suffering to remove the suffering, the ultimate suffering, which is this delusion, this ocean of samsara. It's a delusion. It's fake. It's unreal. It doesn't exist. Gives you suffering to remove the suffering. It's like using a thorn to remove a thorn. You got this big thorn stuck and use a thorn to remove it. Okay. So blessed are the poor in spirit, Jesus said, or they shall be saved, actually. They shall inherit the kingdom or whatever, the world, whatever, but the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. Where I am, there is no doubt. That is the kingdom of God. Created by God, sustained by God. That's the kingdom of God. Not this ridiculous dream that we created God and we're sustaining God, because that's the dream. That's the root of the dream. So if you're suffering, if you're lowly, if you feel, wow, but you're able to practice, you're able to, you know, you're blessed, actually. You're the ones that are blessed. Really blessed. You don't even know how blessed you are. Just make the most of the opportunity. Accept it as best you can. I mean, it's pretty tough for me to just be this super lowly person in the world, where in the past I was some super, super high status person. And now I'm like super, super low status. You know, that is not easy. You know, you talk about having to swallow your pride. Holy cow. I just go around with my head down, you know. Just, it's embarrassing. Embarrassing, you know. But I accept it, you know. I said, okay, it's okay. I know what I'm doing is going to be helpful, so that's how I look at it. It's more important to be helpful than to be viewed as someone really important. What's really important is to be truly helpful and recognizing the samsara is just an illusion, is being super helpful. So if that's more important than being viewed as being important by the world. See, the way the world judges importance is completely catawampus, upside down, backwards, and inside out. They want to figure out how to smooth out this ocean of samsara. How do we smooth this out? Okay, and they look at whoever's doing, you know, got all these ideas, firing their imagination, how to make the world a better place. That's who's important to them. Okay, and someone who's realizing it's all an illusion, there is no world, has no importance to them. But they will, eventually, later on, when they get buyer's remorse of this nonsense, then they'll realize the importance, you know, of this. That's why now I see Jesus, like for instance, Jesus, Longchenpa, Ramana, Sri Sri Anandamayi, those, you know, Nisargadatta, and others. Now I say, wow, they're super important. They're big time. These are the ones that are really important. This is what importance is all about. Big time. So again, if you're in a lowly situation, distressed, you think, how in the world am I ever going to be important? Just thank God and say, thank you, God, for putting me in this position where I don't see any way where I can be important in this world by the world's valuing of importance. There's just no way. How can I do it? I literally can see no way that I can be important in this world. I can't see any avenue or way whatsoever. I feel like I'm doomed to permanent, total irrelevance. That's a blessing. So say, thank you, God, thank you, Holy Spirit, thank you, the grace of, this is wonderful. Thank you for my irrelevance, this is incredible. I don't know how you did it, but you did it, so I'm gonna make the most of it. It's hard to be this irrelevant. I mean, you go around, you see people just coming up from third world, you know, poverty, and they've got this vibrant life going of everyone, so many friends, and people think they're really important, and you just say, wow. I can't do that at all. I mean, I'm just like below the lowest of the low of the low. I can't even see how I can ever get out of that. So that's very humbling, very humbling. You don't want to be a big ship on the ocean of samsara, okay? You don't want to have the biggest yacht. You want to realize there is no ocean of samsara. Never has been, never will be. Where I am, there is no down. Where I am, there is no down. So you might have a sign, I don't have a yacht, because there is no ocean. No yacht, no problem, no ocean. So you might say, I don't even have an ocean. You know, my other car is no ocean. My other yacht is no ocean. I don't have any yachts at all, because I don't even have an ocean. I have peace. How about that? There is no down. Where I am, there is no down. No stormy seas to ride out. No safe harbor to seek. Where I am, there is no down. The sunlight now through the clouds. Okay. That means the rain is, the front has passed through now. So this has been a very good practice because we went through the whole thing. We went through the rain, different intensities. And now the front has passed and here comes the sun behind it. We'll get some sunny weather here for the next day or so, and then another front's supposed to come in Tuesday. This is supposed to be really heavy rain. Supposed to rain for most of the day, and get a real good soaking. That'll be great. That'll be great. Okay, so where I am, there is no down. Where I am, there is no down. This is where I live. This is where I live. This is my lifestyle. This is where I live. Where I am, there is no doubt. This is my lifestyle. This is where I live. Don't make anything of it. Don't make anything of it. Keep that practice going. Keep that practice going. Keep the practice going. And just thank God you have the opportunity to practice like this. Great blessing. Great grace, actually. It's very difficult to find yourself in such a lowly situation in this world, actually, where you have no avenue at all. Very rare. Very rare. Super helpful. Okay. Very great. Don't make anything of it. That's it.